Hi everyone. This talk is about authoring and publishing ES6 modules today. The goals for the talk are to be able to npm publish an ES6 module, require it for your users of the module, and also use it as a script tag. So first, writing an application in ES6, maybe some of you already are doing it. Well, you just have to use Webpack, Browserify, and Babel. So it's easy because you own the environment. You don't have to choose between Browserify or Webpack. You only have it. And then writing a reusable module in ES6, it's a little bit harder. Why? Because we have a lot of different environments. You can be, your users may be using Webpack or Browserify or maybe just Bower or GSPM. Also, you could think, okay, I would just include a Browserify transform or a Webpack loader. But then it is bad because it reduces portability of your module to only people using Browserify or Webpack. Then you could say, okay, I would just publish my module and wait for ES6 to work. But the truth is, right now, for example, the node.js most used versions are 0.10 and 0.12, which are not really good at ES6. For the browsers, that's the same problem because the browser's market share is still very various today with a lot of different support, as you can see on the Kangax ES6 support tables. So we have a lot of green and red saying, okay, this ES6 feature works or doesn't work. So how do we do it? For the NPM users, for example, how do we do it? The solution is to publish ES5 transpiled source code and expose this source code. Let's take an example with an index.js, for example, just a simple ES6 module. So what do? We say, before publishing the module to NPM, I will build the ES6 code to ES5 and expose it. So we have main and pre-published task just to add to the package.json. Then a simple build script will do it with only using Babel and with the out file and out dir. So we compile the whole source folder to ES5. Then this is what we got. We got this module inside our current code. This is what will be pushed and exposed to the NPM user so that your ES6 code is compiled to ES5 and works everywhere. Some traps still, because since you are compiling to ES5, then NPM link is broken because the code that will be linked will be ES6, so it will not work. Require or specify of your module will not work also, because it is only ES6 code. And the JavaScript stack traces also are ES5 stack traces, which do not link well to your code. It may or may not be a big deal depending on of your use case, of your module. So that was for the NPM user, people doing NPM install your module. What about script users that want to use also your cool module? For them, the solution is to publish bundles like an application. So we compile the whole source code into a single file with every module you are using in line into the bundle so that it works. We can use Browserify or Webpack with Babel too. So this is how it looks. You have a Webpack config file where you declare how you want to publish your code. You just have to say that it's a library so that it's exposed to the window. Then in your build script, you have a second directory that will be published to NPM, and then this is this directory that you will be also be able to push to a CDN so that your whole ES5 compiled module will be available to script users. So the summary of today to be able to author ES6 modules is that you cannot directly publish ES6 modules. To author ES6 modules today, you have to compile your code to ES5 and publish it to NPM inside a pre-published task. And for the script users, you have to push an ES5 module to any CDN so that they can use it. As for bonuses, you are able to use JS Deliver and CDNJS or NPM CDN if you want to take an NPM module with a dist file and publish it to a CDN automatically at every new release. You still have to uglify JS your script bundles too, of course. You can avoid publishing to Git by using a Git ignor and NPM ignor, so that once you have an NPM ignor, your dist will go only to NPM and not to Git. And that's it. This is how you...